Hey guys, this is I'm gonna be discussing a deleted scene from the Flash season 8 regarding Tinya tying into the Earth Prime comics that are Arrowverse canon, thanks to Stargirl confirming that. But also Flash season 9 will be bouncing off of that as well. If you guys enjoyed the video, hit the like button down below, subscribe for new notifications, sounds, jump right into the video. So I know Stargirl is on at this point in time, tonight, it's Wednesday, October 19th, 307 was on. I didn't care for it at all, and I'm not going to waste my time doing a 20-minute video when I don't need to. So I'm going to do a video on something that I actually found a lot of interest in, and that I liked watching, which was a deleted scene from Flash season 8. Now, the gag reel went out. We got like 5 deleted scenes, which is something. I think that's probably the most deleted scenes a season's gotten for the show. if not one of the most deleted scenes. Because we got like 4 from Armageddon, 2 from 8:15 Into the Steel Force, 1 from 8:16 The Curious Case by Thurman Allen, 1 from 8:06 and another from 8:13. That's a lot of deleted scenes. We also got one from 8:18. I remember the episode of that. But it was a Mutant's first episode. And we got another deleted scene from 8:20, which is relating to Jay and Joanne in 2049 regarding the Krone arc, which I did talk about in a video I did last week. You can go watch that video where I talked fully about Krone arc and all that. But this is a lot of deleted scenes. And I understand why they cut most of these out, but the one I'm going to be zoning in on specifically is the one from the Flash 8:15 Into the Steel Force, which I think is one of the coolest episodes of the season. And I made very clear in my review that I loved it, and I still do to this day. I rewatch the episode like 6 times alone, and I still love it. The scene revolves around Barry going as the Flash. At this point, Tina doesn't know Barry's the Flash. I don't think she ever finds out, hopefully, at least in the season she doesn't. But in the Earth Prime comics that tie into the Arrowverse, we learn that Tinya is, Phantom Girl, or training to be, with Cisco and Star City at Argus in present-day time. Now, this ties into that. Barry brings up, I was just following Barry being in a Steel Force where he runs into Tinya's mom and can't see Virus, right? This is where they're coming from here. So Barry's telling Tinya all this is a Flash. Again, she doesn't know he's a Flash. I understand why they deleted it. I wish I didn't, but I understand why they did. However, Barry brought up few things about being a hero and all that, and what Tinya can do while waiting for her mom to get back is contact Cisco to go to Argus and learn how to use her powers correctly, because I think if Cisco was there, it would have been a different story arc to where Barry and Cisco would have trained her. Honestly, Barry has enough going on as is, right? And with Phantom Girl's powers, I think it's more accurate to say that Cisco knows more about her type of powers and also can understand them more than Barry can. And also, this is 8:15. Barry has a lot going on to be training someone compared to a non-speedster. That's not only worth the time. Now, Mina Dowen, aka Fast Track, she needed to be trained. She was a speedster, a new speedster, who clearly almost killed people in a fire. in 8:18, I can't talk for the life of me. So that makes sense why they had a trainer. But Tinya, you know, it made perfect sense for her to go to Cisco. So this falls into that timeline of when the Earthbound comics take place. We were kind of just guessing here and there. I assumed it was after the events of Season 8 because Tinya was training with Cisco. I wonder if they deleted that scene specifically for that reason because they want to connect it after Season 8 and not during. But at the same time, I'm also wondering if they deleted it because there wasn't enough time. The entire episode was Barry in a still force. There was no really side plot, from what I remember, in the episode. If I'm wrong, you can correct me, but I'm pretty sure the only side plot, which I don't even remember if there was, but if there was, it was Elena Jones as Seal. That was it. I don't remember anything else. I remember just being very Barry-centric and relating to Still Force and trying to save Iris and to his mom being there. I remember those being the key points of the entire thing. And then Nora showing up and all that. So, again, I understand what scene wasn't in the episode. I wish it was. but I understand why it wasn't. But again, you have to ask a question. Did they delete the scene for A, because the episode was too long and they couldn't put it in, which happened a lot this season, clearly? Or B, was it to make their Prime Comics tie in a little bit better, finally versus season 8 and not during that moment, right? Because what we'd be looking at then is a 5-episode time period from when Tina goes to Star City and starts training and Butterwork escapes to then her coming back and not telling the Flash anything, right? Because Tina was there when Butterwork escaped. Cisco said that in front of her. So I can't imagine if Tina was there in 820, which she was, and they're saying she was in Star City between 815 and 820, that it wouldn't just come up like, oh yeah, you're one of your villains escaped. I think she would bring that up. You know what I mean? Like, it would be a subtle thing, but I'm assuming it's deleted for several reasons in the long run. And 820 would have been a lot different with Tina and the Flash if they kept that scene in. We would have 100% gotten Tina telling the Flash, hey, Butterwork escapes, it's going to me to tell you. Something along those lines. Obviously, that did not happen. Look, I have made very clear that I love season 8. In season 9, I've made very clear as well that I am worried about this season, specifically for the fact that the set photos look like we're going back to season 4, where Barry is the most powerful he's ever been, and then it gets nerfed. Season 8 did an amazing job in not doing that till 8:16. That was the only episode where that really happened. In 8:03, Barry got his speed taken away, but that was by him, his choice, because he thought he was losing his mind, could destroy the city, which he could, but then he got it all back. And, I mean, he did all these things thereafter. None of that nerfed him. They kept buffing him up. He rolled on lightning at 8:12. Jesus, we've never seen him do that. We've seen him do so many things with his powers, but the entire season that we'll never see again in live action for The Flash. Never. The DCU Flash, was Ezra or another person, could pull that off, but it will never come up to what Grant says standard for The Flash. Never. And what the producers did, what the writers did, season 8 should be defining The Flash in every possible level. Season 9... I doubt we're going to see Riding the Lightning or, you know, that massive lightning surge attack. Although I wouldn't be surprised if we did, because we've seen that like 4 or 5 times throughout season 8. So if it calls for it, it will happen. If it doesn't call for it, probably not. However, if there's a speedster villain this season, which Cobalt Blue, assuming it's Cobalt Blue, whoever the next Speedforce avatar is, most likely that will recall for Barry using all his powers and then some, which I'm hoping for. Regarding to Bloodwork and Tina, I would be somewhat surprised if before the series is done, if we don't get Tina in a suit. Not even really in a suit, just using her powers to help Barry defeat some villain. Whether it's Bloodwork or a non-speedster-like villain, that is what will be happening. I can't see them not going down that route. I really don't see that happening. I do think it's fair to say, sorry, I really do think it's fair to say that Tenya will return. I hope it says Phantom Girl and not as anything really just out of nowhere. Obviously, if Tenya returns in season 9, assuming the deleted scene was deleted, specifically for the purpose to make the Earthbound comics tie in better, and to make the writing work out in season 9 and the rest of season 8 as well. If that is the case, we could see Cisco come back with Tenya after he's been training her, and that could be the entire what's going on here. I can't imagine them not doing that. Again, season 9, it looks iffy. At the same time, I don't know. I think it could be good if they know what they're doing. I made it very clear that I trust Eric Wallace. If he thinks having Iris and Barry in the field at the same time to stop a guy who throws boomerangs, which we saw in a set photo, Barry dodged those boomerangs. He went into Flash Time and dodged them. You could see the movement. So why Iris needs to be there, I don't know. And I've talked about that. But the point is the matter of the fact that season 9 can be good or it can be utterly crap. Season 9 will never come close to season 8. I don't care if they bring in Oliver, Supergirl, Wally, they can bring every single person back. It will never top season 8 for me. If they bring in Oliver, I'll give it a lot of leeway. But the point is that what it will come down to is Barry the main focus? It should not be Barry and Iris. It should not be even Tenya. It should be Barry, period. Season 8 really dug into Barry being the Flash, not Iris and Barry. thanks to Todd Helbing, we're stuck with that, apparently. So thank you, Todd Helbing. Appreciate you so much. But look, I really do want to see Tenya in season 9. Her character had a rough start, obviously. I think a lot of these characters did, not only with Eric Wallace, but also Todd Helbing. They had a lot of rough starts, but, I mean, Chester had an amazing season in season 8. Allegra got better. I don't know if she was amazing, but she got better. I think we all agreed both those two characters got better. Maybe we'll talk about Cecile. And Joe and Caitlin and Frost, you know, they all advance in some way, right? Cecile, yeah, Cecile's a seal. At this point, look, I don't keep saying look. Why do I keep saying look? Whatever. My point is that I think it's fair to say Tenya will appear in season 9 with Cisco helping to take down Bloodwork. Again, I don't know why Barry would need help taking down Bloodwork when Martian Manhunter did it on his own in 2049 in Earthbound Comics. You know, it took him a matter of, like, a minute. And it took Barry, what, 30 seconds to defeat him in season 6? So, how fast do you think he'll defeat him now if he returns? It's the final season. Kronark was supposed to be in it, I'm assuming. But I think the problem we're looking at here is 2049 is going to be the main issue in season 9. Obviously, Captain Boomerang is appearing. He'll be recurring. He will not be the main villain the first few episodes. I do think, however, the first few episodes of season 9 will definitely be some type of Armageddon type level event. I don't know what, but I do believe there will be an event slash crossover thing that happens. Do I want that? Kind of iffy, especially if it's relating to Captain Boomerang, hell no. But if it's relating to Bloodwork, wrap up that storyline, as I said before, bring in Tinia as Phantom Girl, there you go. They can easily do that in the first 5 episodes, or 4 even. You can bring in Tyler Superman from Earth Prime, not Superman Lois Earth, because Ty Dobbing won't let that happen. He's made that very clear. Bring in Oliver if you really want to. They're saving for last episodes of the series. And there you go. You can do a lot of things that way with the show if you do it correctly. I think Eric Wallace has a plan. Obviously, things have changed since the season has been announced to be its last. But the matter of the fact is that we are dealing with this being the last season. And you can tell that Eric Wallace, he obviously had no idea. But the setup for Kronark and everything else was going to be put up in season 9. Now, the writers of the Earth Prime comic wrote this probably during the production of season 8. Probably before it even aired, honestly. Or probably like after Armageddon, somewhere between there, they're probably writing it. So, again, what is the case here? Is season 9 going to be finishing up the Earth Prime comics with Bloodwork, Oliver, Tinia, Cisco? I mean, those are 4 characters right there that were all teased to return in season 9, especially Bloodwork, Cisco, and Tinia. I mean, you know, after this lead scene, I think it's fair to say that those 3 characters will be returning season 9 100%. Especially considering it was a delayed scene with Bear and Tinia. Oliver, I don't know. I would assume it's going to be season 9. Because if he appears, the number one thing that'll be in everyone's mind to read these comics are, where's this crisis? Because if Oliver shows up in 902, there's going to be a crisis. And it's going to be bigger than anything Barry's ever faced before. And that's saying something. I mean, the Negative Forces, Thawne, Zoom, Savitar, DeVoe, Cicada, Bloodwork, Now, Then, Eva, however you say your name. I mean, you know, Godspeed, the Forces, whether they're made or not, these were big threats. I mean, they literally threatened the entire city. Whether you like them or not. I mean, really, like, I don't care about DeVoe or Eva or the Forces. I don't think anyone cares about the Forces. But they did cause a massive threat to Central City. And it would not be the final season if there were these villains caused massive threats, let alone to an overpowered Barry Allen as a Flash. Like, we need that in this season. We still need it to continue. So, we need to remember that this is the final season. And no matter what's going on here, there will be things twisted that will be different for this season, obviously. Going into it, it will feel different. And it will feel different nonetheless because it's the final season. But I don't believe Tinia, Phantom Girl. And yeah. Thanks for watching the video. Have a good day. Have a good night. Stay safe. And I'll see you in the next video. Bye, guys.